Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we're going to cover four different functional groups: alcohols, ethers, amines, and halides. And these are going to look really different from each other. However, they all have a commonality. In all cases, the key carbon in the functional group has one bond to a more electronegative heteroatom or electronegative atom. So that puts them in the same or similar oxidation state. So our four functional groups are alcohols, ethers, amines, and halides. So the alcohol has an R group on an oxygen with a hydrogen on the oxygen. Let's see an example. Let's try that differently. Drawing a molecule called methanol. So in this case, our R group on the oxygen is a CH3 group, that's a methyl group, and the key carbon for this functional group is that particular carbon, and that carbon has one bond to a more electronegative atom, that's oxygen. So it belongs within this oxidation state category. Let's draw an example of an ether. We have an oxygen that's attached to now two R groups, two carbon-containing groups. We have two carbons that are attached to our oxygen. Each of those carbons that make this into an ether, each of those carbons have one bond to a more electronegative atom. So these alcohols and ethers are in a similar oxidation state, and as a result, we're going to talk about them together in terms of the chemistry that they perform. Amines, let's draw a specific amine. It's kind of a famous amine in organic chemistry. It's called Hunig's base. There's no need to remember that, but in this amine, we have three different R groups, three different carbon-containing groups, and notice that there are these three carbons, each of them has one bond to a more electronegative atom. That's the nitrogen. So amines are actually related to alcohols and ethers through their common oxidation state. Finally, let's think about halides. This is just a simple alkyl chloride. Our R group is an ethyl group. This carbon right here has one bond to a more electronegative atom. That's chlorine. And so therefore, it also falls under this umbrella of functional groups that have one carbon electronegative atom bond. So we treat these together. They look very differently. Actually, the chemistry for all these molecules follows a lot of similar trends. So we'll learn about them together when we learn about chemistry, not just when we learn about oxidation states.